thank you to all our viewers watching coast to coast and everywhere else. We're just about ready for the 63rd annual Wing Open from here at the United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs. Things just a little bit delayed, so stick around. We'll be back with you momentarily. United States Air Force Academy in a windy day in Colorado Springs as we are just about ready for the 63rd annual Wing Open Boxing Championship. Roland Vargas joined ringside by Kaneda Clifton Smith, a two-time Wing Open champion. It's an honor to have you alongside us, sir.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here.
We will get this one underway momentarily. All of the fighters in the ring will start at 119 pounds. In just a moment, just a pound over the bantam weight limit. As we get ready to get that underway, we've got some cadets also in attendance, as well as some dignitaries from across the United States Air Force. Get a great look there, ringside of the cadets here, the United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs, as we pause for a moment for our national anthem. standing at attention for our national anthem as I bring in my broadcast partner, Mr. Clifton Smith. And sir, just tell me a little bit about what the Wing Open means here at the United States Air Force Academy to these boxers and these athletes.
Oh man, where do I begin? It means a lot of things. It's just like the grand finale of, you know, all the work you've put in leading up to that point. And it just really, it's really a showcase of not only your hard work, but you know, the growth over the years, because a lot of these boxers are like, you know, 1, 2 and 3-time returners. So just seeing that growth over time, it becomes like a really special and near and dear to the heart thing. Like, I still remember like my Wing Open last year like it was yesterday, because it's just that potent of an experience. But it means everything. And usually, COVID notwithstanding, winning this fight here is your gateway to compete at the regional and national level. But even without that being a guarantee this season, like, it still doesn't take away from any of the meaning behind the fight. But yeah, it's just a explosion of everything that you've been, you know, putting in up to this point, the blood, sweat, and the tears.
And how much does it change from your perspective as an athlete who's been in this crucible before, just fighting against someone that you've been training with each and every day, someone that you go to school with every day? How is that different than perhaps another fight against another school?
I feel like it's much more rewarding and like filled with good intention, because fighting another teammate, you know, you feel like you're like fighting a friend. So it, as crazy as it sounds, like, and as hard as you guys are hitting each other, it's all out of love, and it's like you're fighting your teammate, and like the overarching goal is to like get better. And then, you know, when you're fighting a person that isn't from your team, you can put all the bad intention behind those punches, and you know, really put everything that you've been working on with your teammates to work to beat an opponent that's not on your team. So I think that, you know, things like Friday night fights and like all the sparring we do in practice really like leads to a much better fight when it's time to fight like a person from another school, because like we don't go easy on each other. We go very hard. We push each other. We, you know, just push all those limits so that when somebody else pushes those, we're ready to do it.
Would you rather win a fight here at the Wing Open, or would you rather knock somebody out who goes to the military academy?
Definitely knock somebody. Oh man, that's a tough one. I would definitely want to knock somebody out that like went to West Point and Navy, just because it's West Point and Navy. But this is a very, very close second. Yeah.
You were, of course, the 2-time Wing Open champion at 175 pounds, as we see the fighters being introduced here in the ring. We'll have 12 bouts this evening. Get ready with a fight at 119 pounds here in just a moment. You mentioned the training that you guys do together with this boxing team. How different is it to change into this kind of a mode here for the Wing Open, as opposed to sparring behind closed doors when the cameras aren't on, when the lights aren't on, when you're not here in Clune Arena?
I think it definitely can take, you know, definitely for the first timers and for a lot of the freshmen here, it can definitely take them off guard a little bit. And it's just a completely different environment. Even like as a senior, my senior year, like just going from, you know, the last time they sparred was probably last Friday, and you know, to go from that environment to this, although very close in frequency, like it's just completely different, like under all the lights and just the awes and oohs from the crowd. So I think you can definitely, you know, if you're not thinking from the perspective of, I need to be able to like stay calm and poised in front of all these people, like it can definitely take you off guard. And I feel like we're going to see that a little bit in these fights. Like you're going to see some people like kind of, it definitely fuels the nerves a lot. And I think that's something that we ultimately like aim to nip in the bud in practice. It's just like, like being able to fight in front of large crowds. So like some practices we'll fight, like we'll spar and like go through practice, and the whole time like crowd cheers would be going, just so we get used to staying calm in such a anti-environment. So yeah, it's very different, and I'm excited to see how they handle the pressure from the crowd.
That is, of course, one of the most important things, how you were able to turn it on here for the Wing Open, the 63rd Wing Open. The United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs. First up, as we mentioned, we'll have a fight at 119 pounds between the junior Ryan Dindorf and the freshman Noah Sherman. Dindorf from Bedford, New Hampshire. Sherman out of San Diego, California. Fighters will just go back to their respective dressing rooms before coming out. What would you say, sir, the most important thing mentally to stay focused, to be able to perform on this event, something that, as you mentioned, you've been working up to, something that you've been training to? What do the coaches try to instill in you guys? What do the fighters try to instill between each other in order to stay focused for this event?
I think it's just like just the essence of, you know, giving it like your all, and then once you come to the point where your all is extinguished, giving it 10 times more than that. And I think like we are really, really hard on each other for good reasons, because when we get put, you know, when we get put out into the ocean that is like, you know, intercollegiate competition, like we have to bring it, and we want to be able to not only be the better fighter from a physical standpoint, but we want to mentally break down the opponent. And I think that's, you know, we just get in the habit of like treating every sparring opportunity, if it's like, even if it's as small as drill or as big as full spar, like we have to approach that with intention and with the perspective like you're fighting or like you're preparing for an intercollegiate fight. So yeah,
we are just about ready to go. Good look at Noah Sherman, freshman from San Diego, California, went to Santana High School, the Sultans up in Santee, northeast of San Diego. He'll be squaring off against Ryan Dindorf, the junior from Bedford, New Hampshire, just a hair west of Manchester. So we welcome you inside Clune Arena.
I'm excited to see what this is that example of growth I was talking about. Like last time Dindorf was here, he had to fight RJ Leon, and RJ was a really, really great fighter, and just to see how he performs on his I think this is his second or third showing at the Wing Open. I want to see what tools have been added to his bag.
Going up against the freshman, fighters will circle each other and exchange half blows. 119-pound fight. Welcome you into Colorado Springs, Clune Arena on the campus of the United States Air Force Academy on a windy day. Quick blows being exchanged by these two fighters. Dindorf looking to land that right. Nice little right over the top there. Nice little combo as well. Fighter staying off the ropes here. Early doors, our first fight. And this is the 63rd annual Wing Open.
Just setting it up.
Nice little combo there against the ropes. Don't want to get caught there. Quick little 1-2 and then out. A nice crowd on hand tonight here in Clune Arena. Perhaps one of the last events we'll see before the snow this weekend.
Indeed. It's supposed to snow really bad.
Even worse than Denver.
Yeah.
Measuring it in feet these days.
It's been a very warm week too. It's crazy to see it like go back and forth like that.
Flirting with 70 and then flirting with 5 inches of snow up in the mountains. Welcome to Colorado. Once again on the ropes. Just a little step back out. Good feet there from Dindorf.
Sherman is being really good about the pressure. Hopefully he can keep it up.
Good fighting out of the corner there. It was a nice shot landed with the right hand to the top of the head as they broke from the corner. That'll be the end of round number one. Your thoughts on that one?
I think it was, I think Dindorf is finding his footing during the first half of the first round, but now that he's been more on the front foot towards the end, I think I'm excited to see who's going to dominate these next couple rounds, because they both displayed real good use of pressure, stayed on the front foot. Dindorf's bag is a lot deeper, but we'll see what Mr. Sherman has to say about that.
Yeah, Dindorf with the red gloves, get a good look at the young man there. Comes from an athletic family. His father competed in track and field with the engineers of MIT. His mother was a swimmer at Tufts.
Wow, that is, yeah, that is amazing.
The Jumbos of Tufts University.
It's crazy because when you're in the ring, like, it's almost like your opponent is the only thing you see. Like, I couldn't see the crowd. I couldn't see anything until the end of the fight. And it's like you're just so locked in and dialed in.
Nice little opening exchange from Sherman. Dindorf tries to back him up into the ropes. Has some success there. Good start to this second round from Sherman. Nice left there over the top.
It's a nice jab from Sherman.
See just how quick these fighters are with just 119 pounds to carry around. Good job there not coming together with the head. It was a nice little jab from Dindorf just to keep his distance. Sherman gets inside the guard. Nice little shot there down the middle from Sherman. Tries to follow it up with the right. Dindorf catching some of the gloves. Left in the second round here in Colorado Springs. Good fight to open the 63rd annual Wing Open.
Sherman's being really good about the pressure, just keeping Dindorf on the back foot.
Seems like he's dominating the center of the ring here in this second round. Dindorf looking to close the space. Bit of a mark on that nose does Ryan Dindorf. Nice little duck out.
Movement.
Yeah, it was a nice little duck out there from Sherman. Sherman trying to catch Dindorf in the corner. Referee breaks him up. 5 seconds remaining here in the second round. All action fight so far. Pretty good action to begin this Wing Open.
Pretty good fight.
Certainly is.
Good interesting look. To see how this third round plays out. I feel like Sherman kind of, he's on the front foot a little bit more than Dindorf this round, but Dindorf, interesting to see how he can turn it around and use or get in his bag this third round.
Take a look
good
at
good combos.
Yeah, take a look at some of the action from that action-packed second round. Good look there at Noah Sherman, member of Squadron 10, fancies himself a bit of a spear fisherman when he's at home in California.
Spear fishing is pretty cool. Never done it. Hope to do it at some point, but that's super cool.
We've got a couple different cadets that list spear fishing as their favorite hobby. Wow. Here on the notes. We'll get into that later. You won't be surprised to hear that the others hail from the great state of Hawaii.
Wow.
Just about ready for round number three here in Colorado Springs, and we are off and underway. All action fight so far between Noah Sherman and Ryan Dindorf at 119 pounds. Getting this wing open. Nice little right from Sherman.
See if Dindorf can get in his bag.
The first time that Dindorf has looked for that uppercut with the right hand. That one unable to land as Sherman just backed out. Sherman caught against the ropes. Both fighters going for it here in the third.
Go first, Ryan.
Dindorf showing a little bit of wear and tear first, on that nose.
There you go, Dindorf. When he throws, he lands.
Good body shots there as well, trying to lower the hands of Noah Sherman. Once again with the body shot there to the rib cage from the right hand of Ryan Dindorf. Caught him again with the body shot.
Change.
Favoring Dindorf these last couple moments, wouldn't you say, sir?
Yes, sir. I think he's finally using the tools that he's been working so hard on these last couple months. Just in his bag.
Yeah, you can see the experience of the junior coming to the fore here, Ryan Dindorf. Sherman, just a freshman here at the United States Air Force Academy. 30 seconds remaining in round number three.
At a very good point to be a freshman, to be able to compete like this with a seasoned boxer like Dindorf is really good. It's a very promising USAFA boxing career ahead of him.
Certainly does, the freshman from Southern California. 10 seconds remaining in the fight. Nice little left there from Dindorf. Closes in on Sherman. Another left down the pipe. And that'll be it. What a great fight. All action fight to start this 63rd annual Wing Open.
Good fight. I think a big part of the nerves that the crowd bring too is like kind of sticking to your strategy, because you would be thinking about what to hit the person with or how you want to exploit this weakness that they demonstrate. But when you get in there, it's like your mind goes blank. So finding your way back to what you originally planned to do is a challenge too. And I think Dindorf did a good job of that in that third round.
You can see the experience come to the front from Ryan Dindorf as we await the judges' scorecard. Fantastic way to start the Wing Open here in Colorado Springs. Back and forth fight, both fighters exchanging well in the center of the ring. A couple times Sherman got caught on the ropes, but he did a tremendous job to fight his way out. Great look there at Ryan Dindorf. Young man from Bedford, New Hampshire. Fighters still have a good spring in their step as they make their case to the ringside judges.
Wonder what the decision is going to be.
I would imagine it would favor Ryan Dindorf, but I spent a lifetime being wrong. I will be again, I'm sure.
Yeah, I think the first two rounds definitely would give the first one to Sherman. Two could be, that would be like a split. Then third, I would give to Ryan. We'll see. Wow, yeah.
Upset. Noah Sherman, the freshman. Great respect there shown between those two fighters. So your 2021 Wing Open champ at 119 pounds, the freshman out of San Diego, California, Noah Sherman.
It's a great feeling to win a Wing Open your freshman year.
Yeah, you mentioned what he has ahead of him here at his career at the United States Air Force Academy. What a fantastic way to start in his first time to the Wing Open. The win for Noah Sherman by judge's decision. We get ready for our second fight here in Colorado Springs. Good look there at Lawrence Barrett. He's a 125-pound junior from Hualalua, Hawaii, on the Big Island. He was a wildcat in high school at Kona Wanea. Our champion at 125 pounds last year in the Wing Open. Also a champion in 2019 as marching out Leo Macho Camacho, the freshman from the great city, a city that you're familiar with, sir, Chicago, Illinois.
Wow, I never knew that. Chicago, Illinois.
Went to Glendard East High School, the Rams, in far western Chicago in Lombard.
Oh, we used to have, when I ran track in high school, we had a track meet at that school. Real big school. It's a nice school.
You, of course, sir, fighting out of Southland College Prep, the Eagles in Richton Park, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, sir, the Eagles. We were a pretty tiny school, and we had one cool story. We got like beat by 110 points by the number one school in the nation at the time, Morgan Park.
Wow.
High School. Fun game. Not for us, though. Fun to watch.
We are ready. 125-pound bout. Leo Camacho, Lawrence Barrett. Camacho in the all blue. Barrett in the silver and black.
Right to it.
Yeah, not messing around. These two. Barrett trying to close the space.
Barrett I've watched him work on what you're seeing now every day since I've been on the team. And he's gotten really good at just closing the distance, you know, moving ahead, just sticking and moving and constantly putting pressure on his opponent. I think Barrett's become a real, real good user of that. And he's eating the body up.
Yeah, three straight body shots right to the belly button. There's a fourth there from the junior Lawrence Barrett, the two-time wing open champ. Leo Camacho looks for the uppercut, just not able to set it up. You can see those elbows already trying to protect that midsection. Barrett right back to it. Nice little headshot there from Lawrence Barrett.
Good foot movement. Barrett's just moving really well. Real glad to see all this stuff come together.
Flying Hawaiian Lawrence Barrett.
Oh, I heard that.
Yeah, we can hear that ringside in our wonderful position here in Clune Arena. Leo Camacho trying to exchange when they break. So far, the better of this fight going to the fighter with the red gloves, Lawrence Barrett. Experience of Barrett. Camacho with the little left. Didn't really seem to hurt Barrett.
Barrett has his hands in a great spot, and the pressure's forcing Leo to fight at Barrett's distance. Leo being the taller fighter, by the looks of it, Leo wants to stay at a distance, but Barrett is keeping that pressure on him, and the fight's moving in his direction now.
Yeah, fantastic first round. We'll take a look back at some of that action. You see there, lovely combination from Lawrence Barrett. Nice right as well. Some of those body shots followed by, once again, a quick little combination to the head. Good look there at Leo Camacho. Goes by the nickname Macho, as you would have to do. Your last name is Camacho. Shout out to the Hall of Famer Hector Macho Camacho, Southpaw from Puerto Rico.
Wow.
Lost him in 2012 after just a stellar career, 79 wins and 6 losses.
Wow.
At the professional level for Hector Macho Camacho. Good look at Lawrence Barrett, 125-pound junior out of Hawaii.
Looks like he's chilling. He's probably one of the faster distance runners on the team too, like just cooks on 3+ mile runs. See that all play out in the ring too.
Here for the second round. Camacho certainly under a lot of pressure in that first from Barrett. Barrett with the strong right hand. Tempo eased off just a little bit at the beginning of this second. As soon as I say that, back to it, exchanging punches.
Right back to it. Barrett's also just deep in his bag, using all the tools he has. And you can see how the strategy changes too from round one to round two, and it kind of throws your opponent off a little bit. And you know, third round he can mix them all up and just leave his opponent on his toes.
How important is that from your experience, just the history that you've had here at the Air Force Academy boxing, and what you can bring, what you can do sort of in your own mind to change things as you go round to round when you're facing a younger opponent?
I think one of the biggest things that clicked for me was realizing that it's not just like you're not getting in there and just like fighting, like you're getting in there and you're playing a really calculated game of chess. And I think the sooner you realize that, the sooner you'll see those skills. Because, like, you know, anybody can throw a jab, a right hand, and an uppercut. But depending on how and when you decide to throw those determines who will win the fight. So I think, like, you know, if you can come up with a strategy and put that into action in the ring, I think that's very important to do. Because, you know, without a strategy, you're just essentially in there just throwing punches aimlessly. So yeah, I think Bear is doing a great job of using his strategy to his advantage. Leo as well.
Yeah, Bear able to weather some of those shots from Leo Macho Camacho. We tick down 10 seconds remaining here in an all-action second round in Colorado Springs, Clune Arena. Pleasure to have you along with us for the 63rd annual Wing Open. It was a nice jab from Barrett, and that'll bring an end to the second round. Just a moment, we'll take a look back at some of that action. Right there, as promised, Barrett pushing the pace, Camacho trying to back his opponent up, landed a nice little right hand there, followed by a left, and then Camacho, you can see the power, some of that experience starting to shine through from the young man from Hawaii. Get a good look at him there.
Real excited about the freshman class. We got a lot of good fighters, lots of experience, and in 2 to 3 years, they're going to be nails. They're going to be really good, and we're going to have like a really, really solid team. So very excited for the future.
Heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen. Air Force Academy, great freshman class. Take a look at one of those, Leo Macho Camacho from Chicago, Illinois, as we mentioned. Look at him there in his corner.
Like his tattoos, cool tattoos. If I got in a ring with somebody that had tattoos like that, I'd be kind of scared, not gonna lie.
Ready for round three. The tattooed Camacho, he's got a brother serving as a paratrooper in the Army, currently stationed in Alaska.
Wow, that's dope.
Wonder what their forecast for the next few days is.
I can only imagine if it's snowing out here. Alaska gets like, they have like some periods where like it's night for like a couple days. That would be I would sleep for 3 days straight, probably.
I remember that game from my time in Sweden. And I was in southern Sweden, I didn't even have it bad. Bright all day for part of the year, and dark all night.
Wow. It would be so weird to wake up at like 3 a.m. and still see the sun up. That would be, that would be weird.
You got to invest well in your blind selection at the local IKEA. Nice little right there from Camacho. Barrett takes it well. Barrett closing the space, trying to dominate the center of the ring. The experienced fighter. Junior now, two-time Wing Open champion is Lawrence Barrett.
I think Barrett's doing a really good job of reading Camacho, his punches, because he kind of flares his left. So whenever, you know, he's getting ready to throw a jab, he opens up a little bit, and Barrett just throws a straight jab down the middle.
It's a wonderful left hook from Barrett, caught the temple of Camacho, right hand from Barrett, did a little bit of damage. Camacho doing a great job taking all punishment coming toward him. Exchanges there with a left of his own and then a right. Barrett looking comfortable. Camacho not going to give this one up. 10 seconds remaining in this bout. Fantastic fight here. We've seen two wonderful fights.
There it is. Just, man, great fight.
Yeah, tremendous fight. Great end to it. You see the camaraderie, the sportsmanship, the class on show. Leo Camacho, the freshman, Lawrence Barrett, there he is, the junior. Would you say that Barrett shaded that fight?
Yeah, Barrett definitely won that, in my opinion. I think that this is good, too, because, like, they fight a lot in practice. And, you know, fighting somebody that's, like, you know, at a more mature point than you in your boxing career is so good because it just makes you so much better. So much better.
Take a look at some of the action from that fight. Just two brilliant fights to start the 63rd annual Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Great sportsmanship shown between those two. we await once again the judges' scorecard ringside here at Clune Arena in Colorado Springs. Barrett on the right of your screen, Macho Camacho on the left. Joke with the officials is Lawrence Barrett. Attended the prep school before making his way up to the Air Force Academy. Lists among his dislikes shirts.
I don't like shirts either. Sometimes when it's cold, put on a shirt.
Lawrence Barrett. Man who does not like a shirt, but he'll be getting a medal right here three times in a row. A wing open champion at 125 pounds, defeating Leo Macho Camacho on the judges' scorecard. Fantastic second fight in the end. Barrett, your winner at 125 pounds.
And Leo's really, like I said before, with him and Sherman, very, very solid freshman class, and I'm really excited to see what they bring to the table when they're seniors. When he's in Barrett's shoes, it's going to be a crazy, crazy sight. And he might have more tattoos.
Ready here for our first women's fight of the evening. Good look there at Sharina Staten, the senior from Bartlesville, Oklahoma, about 50 miles or so north of Tulsa. She was a Bruin in high school at Bartlesville High School. She will be squaring off against a sophomore, Brooke Martin. Brooke Martin fighting out of Vacaville, California. There is Martin. Was a Wildcat in high school at Will C. Wood. Same high school as Jermaine Dye, the 2005 World Series MVP. Brooke Martin, just a sophomore. Staten, the senior, this fight at 132 pounds. Just a hair over super featherweight. Staten with the experience. She was the wing open champion last year, all the way down at 112 pounds. Grandfather Kenneth Wheat served as a Marine in World War II, and her cousin Zach Wheat is an enlisted member of the Air Force for Sharina Staten, so she comes from a military family. Staten with the red gloves, there she is. Brooke Martin with the blue gloves.
Real excited for this fight, especially for Shay. She, just seeing her when she first came down to now, like something clicked and she just got mean in the ring. So I'm excited to see how she puts that together.
Brooke Martin out of her corner, fast as lightning there, got a height and reach advantage over Staten. Staten there, nice little exchange. All action fight here, start our third fight. We haven't missed any time at the wing.
Wow.
Open. Quick stoppage as the headgear comes off Brooke Martin. What a start to this fight though. Just letting the trainers in to reapply the headgear. Martin, young lady from Vacaville, California.
That headgear is very slippery.
It's our first exchange of the fight. That thing just went flying off under the pressure being applied by Sharina Staten. Everything back in order. Minute 43 remaining here in the first round. 132 pounds. Staten crouching and attacking from that low position. Nice right hand.
Yeah, Shay is, she is mean. She is mean in the ring.
Senior from Oklahoma. Once again, Staten from that low position firing up at the taller Brooke Martin. Staten listed at 5'2", Martin at 5'9".
Staten's doing a real good job of just keeping the pressure on her, standing on the front foot. And when she gets inside, she's throwing. like as you can see with Brooke, it's very hard to throw inward as a much taller fighter. So she's just exploiting all of those openings as much as she can. It's good to see.
How important is it for the taller fighter in Brooke Martin just to try to keep some of that space and be able to use that reach that she has?
Man, that is life or death. If you can't keep your space as a tall fighter and you fight as somebody that's good at infighting, man, it's not going to end well for you. So that's from the jump, we Coach Baldy and Coach Green just try to hammer home the simple one and two before anything else, because that's going to save you in a lot of different situations, especially being the one with the reach.
Fighting a real tenacious fighter here, and Sharina State backs Martin up into the corner. Martin, good footwork to get out of it. Taking a little bit of punishment as she does, then exchanging. All action first round. Scene is now our third fantastic fight of the evening here from Colorado Springs. 10 seconds remaining in the first round. That Martin dealing with the headgear that came off, and then that white piece of fabric she has there was pulled down over her eyes. That's why we saw that second stoppage, as we take a look back at some of the action from that first round. There is the helmet coming off early. Seemed like it surprised Brooke Martin more than anything else. Martin looking to keep that distance. State getting inside the pocket and exchanging.
The helmet had a hard time handling the meanness of Shay. She brings it. Water tastes so good when you're in between rounds. It's like life juice.
No Gatorade, no Powerade, just a water man yourself?
Yeah, I'm a big advocate of water. I feel like the water tastes so much better when you're tired, like when you're exhausted. And it almost tastes like juice. But when you're not tired, it just tastes kind of plain. But maybe that's just me.
No, I respect it. I concur. Just about ready for the second round. We are underway. Brooke Martin at the blue glove, Sharina Staten in the red. Fight here at 132 pounds.
You can really see the conditioning come out in all of these fights, actually. Shay's one of the more conditioned fighters on the team, and she just goes from round one to round three.
She's got that head down, always attacking, looking to get inside with Brooke Martin in exchange. She's been able to do that. Whisk the helmet off Martin early in this fight. There is State, nice little combo. That right hand back Martin up a few steps. Nice little right hand again from Staten.
Good to see her center of gravity so low, because that's where the power comes from in the punches. And Martin being so tall and her naturally being above Staten, Staten just can whip her whole body into her punches and you know, knock Martin a few steps back. Martin's also a lot more poised in the ring, too, from my first time seeing her. I think that was my junior year, seeing her come down. From then to now, she looks a lot more polished and poised and a lot more comfortable in the ring, and that's super good to see.
She was listed previously at 156, now down to 132 for Brooke Martin. Just under 30 seconds remaining here in the second round. The first women's fight of the evening in Colorado Springs. First year that women fought here at the Academy, 2016. Shout out to Lieutenant Colonel Steve Simon for passing that along to us pre-broadcast.
Yeah, I was super excited to see him mesh the teams. This is my sophomore year. Like, now, you know, the guys and the gals practice together. We're all under one roof and grow together. Super dope.
Get a good look there at some of the action that we saw in that back and forth second round here in Colorado Springs. It's actually 2015, the first year that the women fought at the Air Force Academy. That was me getting that wrong, not Lieutenant Colonel Steve Simon. Blame me, not him. Good look there at Shea Staten, young lady from Bartlesville, Oklahoma, just north of Tulsa. Former member of the cross-country team here at the Academy. Should be a great third round that we have in store. 132-pound fight. Underway, third and final round here at the Air Force Academy, 63rd annual Wing Open. Fighters circling. Good early exchange.
Good angles from Shea.
Just darting around real quickly there.
Yeah, it really throws your opponent off because they just have to like adjust to where you at. And by the time they're done adjusting, a punch is coming your way. So, real good.
Yeah, it seems like Brooke Martin just hasn't been able to get the timing down on some of her combinations due to, as you mentioned, some of that movement perhaps from Shea Staten.
Yeah, Shea's just really good at being on the inside. I don't think Brooke has fought a person that was as good at that as Shea was. So I know usually Brooke would like to stay at, you know, real friendly distance where she can just land the 1-2 and move around, but Shea being Shea, she won't let that happen. So, but Brooke is being a lot better about throwing her straight punches than she was at the start of her tenure as a U.S. softball boxer. So it's good to see her put in the stuff that she worked on together in the ring.
Once again, keeping that distance close is Staten. Look for that right hand over the top. Brooke Martin able to back out inside of a minute remaining in this third and final round. Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Action kind of tailed off maybe a little bit in this third round, but an all-action fight in the first two. Staten tries to get that right hand in. That one lands. Both fighters breathing heavy now as we tick down toward 10 seconds remaining in this fight. Staten certainly edging the first couple of rounds, the senior.
Oh, good job. Oh.
And that'll be it right at the bell, as if to punctuate it. Sharina Staten with a right hand connecting to the top of the head of Brooke Martin. And once again, third fight in a row, we will go to the judges' scorecard. Surely has to favor Staten, the experienced fighter.
Yeah, I believe so too.
Wonderful fight. We take a look back at some of the action from that third round, the championship round here in Colorado Springs. Wonderful look there at Sharina Staten.
Definitely would get us to Sharina. Also still happy to see Brooke, like all the growth that Brooke has brought to the ring too. But yeah, Shea just something just, she just came to practice one day, just different when she fought, and been real working out real well for her, because ever since then she hasn't seen many losses from, you know, in Friday night fights or on the road.
The winner of the Wing Open at 112 pounds last year was Staten. As we await the judges' scorecard ringside here at Clune Arena. Good PA announcer does. Shea Staten, your winner once again, second straight Wing Open championship for Staten. Credit also, though, as you said, to Brooke Martin. She put up a tremendous fight.
Great
as
fight.
Well.
Yeah, the announcer, the weights always make me kind of nervous. Really cool, though, especially in a closer fight when they pause like that. Like, you really don't know who can get the W. But good job on the announcer, keeping us on our toes.
Fighters will walk off together as we get ready for a fight on the men's side, also at 132 pounds, between one of our team captains, Will Winstead. He's a 5'10", 132-pound lightweight senior. There he is, out of Haymarket, Virginia. That's about 45 minutes due west of our nation's capital. was a Battlefield Bobcat in high school was Will Winstead. The semifinalist all the way back in 2018 at 147 pounds at the Wing Open. And he will be squaring off against a junior fighting out of Arizona, went to Desert Vista High School, the Thunder, Don Angelo Piasecki from the South Phoenix area. Won a couple of state championships on the cross-country team in high school, did Piasecki Winstead. On the left of your screen in the blue, Winstead in the silver and black.
Excited to see what Winstead has to bring to the table too. He's been working real hard, grinding every day from the day he came on my sophomore year to now. It's like what all that work leads up to. So I'm excited to see what he does, especially as the team captain too. Got some big shoes to fill, but I'm confident he'll fill them with grace.
This fight here, once again, like our last fight, at 132 pounds, lightweight fight. Once again, an all-action start. These fighters so far in this 63rd annual Wing Open not waiting around after that opening bell. Good exchange there. A couple of hard shots landed by Winstead.
Man, super hard.
Could hear that second one and see some of the Vaseline go flying off the face of Piasecki after Winstead landed that early right. Good exchange again, nice left from Winstead.
Oh, that was good. Okay.
Referee satisfied. You could hear the clap ringside. Winstead got a lot of power in that right hand. He's looking to land it. A half clinch there. Fighters break out of it. Nice right there from Piasecki. Junior from the South Phoenix areas. Don Angelo, a.k.a. D'Angelo Piasecki.
That was a good jab from Piasecki.
Nice right from Winstead. Knocked the head back of Piasecki. Referee happy to let things continue. 30 seconds remaining here, good round too. Number one.
Yeah, I think Winstead is another one of those boxers that something just woke up one day different. And, you know, has boxed much, much, much better from that day forward. And he just found his rhythm and he just stays there. It's good to see.
Nice end of the first round from Piasecki. And that will be that for just an all-action back and forth first round. Fourth straight one that we've seen at the Wing Open. Good look there at Don Angelo Piasecki. We'll take a look at some of the action from the first.
Yeah, Will came out there swinging. Just so much whip in the hips. You can just see the power and the strength coming off the punches. But yeah, Will Winstead has been working really hard. So is Piasecki too. Just seeing them both just work hard and, you know, be super intentional and in the ring and all that come together tonight is super dope. And I'm sure all my other buddies watching from home that graduated last year will agree.
See, neither of these fighters missing any days in the weight room.
Oh yeah, both just, yeah.
Winstead, especially that upper back, just.
Man, the traps, you can sit coffee cups on those.
Yep. Looking more shredded than a julienne salad is Will Winstead. Ready for round number two. Don Angelo Piasecki with the blue gloves, Will Winstead with the red.
Yeah, I also think it's because of, I think this is the most weight Winstead has had to cut, because yeah, he's fighting at 132. He used to be at 147, so cutting that much weight is no easy task. But your body does thank you for it, especially when you're taking pictures in the mirror or something, no shirt or something. You just see just all like every all this all the fat is just gone.
Especially under the lights here.
Yeah.
At Clune Arena. Had Winstead listed from last year at 139. You mentioned it moving even further down.
Yeah,
of course.
Yeah, he had to move down quite a bit.
Of his career, 5'10", Winstead, 5'8", is Piasecki. Fight maybe gone off the boil just a little bit at the beginning of this second round. Fighters exchange jabs. Good little 1-2 from Winstead. Look there, courtside, ringside, I should say. Too used to being in Clune Arena. Winstead whips the head back of Piasecki. A little combo, though, in response from Donangelo Piasecki, the junior.
Yeah, I think, you know, not to toot our own horns, but I think, you know, fighting with the 20ers has made the 21ers and 22ers and even 23ers just like a look at boxing from a different perspective, you know, because we just brought like I was saying earlier about, like, you know, being in the ring with another teammate and them, you know, pushing you to your limits. Like, we really worked to push them to their limits. So I think, you know, that was a great gateway to that growth.
End of round number 2. All right. A shout out to Will Winstead's parents, William and Treva, both served in the United States Army. Has a twin sister who's a member of the crew team at George Mason. There's Winstead. Good look at some of the action from that second round.
Yeah, really, really sticking it to him there. All those punches.
Yeah, not as furious as the first round that we had in Colorado Springs, but once again, a very high quality round of boxing here at 132 pounds in the lightweight division. Good look at Donangelo Piasecki.
It's actually clinically proven that the more tattoos you have, the stronger, the harder you punch, and the scarier you look in the ring. I think that's a new tattoo from Piasecki, though, the one on the chest. That's nice.
I can tell you from experience in the tattoo chair that is not a proven fact. You could not punch any lighter than I do, despite being covered head to toe. We're ready for the third round in Colorado Springs. Will Winstead with the red gloves, Piasecki with the blue. Nice little left from Winstead. Piasecki responds, fixes his headgear in the process. Referee just bringing a stop for some extra tape that he rips off the left wrist of Piasecki. Back underway. Nice exchange once again from Will Winstead.
I'm going back and forth between the gloves and Winnie's traps. Winstead's traps are very, they look like they're just etched in his back.
Looking like both fighters are made out of marble here. This little exchange, referee let them clinch. The fighters broke out of it on their own. Referee just going to bring a stop. I believe we saw a flying mouthpiece.
Man, the flying mouthpiece, when you put it, when my mouthpiece flew out, I forgot when that was. I think it was my first time at the Wing Open. It was on the ground, and they didn't wash it off. Mm. I just put it back in my mouth, and it tasted, it didn't taste how I expected it to. But yeah, that was pretty gross. Glad they washed it off.
Great exchange from Piasecki, backing Winstead up. Best little action of the fight. Nice combination from Donangelo Piasecki. Standing count for Winstead. Tremendous action from Piasecki. Once again, mouthpiece is out. It'll get a rinse in these COVID times before going back to Will Winstead. Nice little extra breather for Winstead after that barrage from Piasecki. 20 seconds remaining in this fight. Piasecki looking to etch his name on the judges' scorecard. Dislodges the headgear once again of Will Winstead. Will Winstead comes back. Nice little flurry of his own. 10 seconds remaining. All action into this fight here in Colorado Springs. Both fighters swinging from the hip. Wow. Beautiful combination from Piasecki.
Wow, just going. Man, it's all in the traps. All in the traps.
Throwing bombs there to end that fight. What a fight. Perhaps the fight of the evening so far.
That was a great fight.
In Clune Arena, we take a look at some of the action from that third round.
You can tell you can just see the will to win in both of them. Piasecki really turned that up this last round.
Fabulous fight, fabulous end for Piasecki. Looked like Winstead certainly had etched it in the first, and then Piasecki there with that wonderful combination, just a barrage of punches, 1, 2, 3 after another, pushing Winstead into the corner. Referee forced to go to the standing count after that flurry from the fighter with the blue gloves, Don Angelo Piasecki. Good look there at the senior Will Winstead, young man out of Haymarket, Virginia. Go to the judges' scorecard once again. Your thoughts on that fight, sir, and which way the judges are going to lean?
Man, I think I'll give it to Winnie by a split. I think Piasecki definitely did a good job of turning it up the third round, but you know, the first and second, Winnie was just coming with just a force facilitated by his traps. But yeah, I think I would give it to Winnie in a split. But honestly, since it's a split, it can go either way, but we'll see. Hopefully the announcer doesn't pause and make us nervous this time.
You said it. Just a fantastic fourth fight of the evening here in Colorado Springs. Just about ready for the judges' scorecard between Will Winstead and Don Angelo Piasecki.
Oh, wow. Oh, man. Heart just dropped.
Fantastic respect once again shown between these two warriors. Piasecki crestfallen not to see his hand raised, but a tremendous fight from Will Winstead. Piasecki certainly won that third round, but you could easily say that Will Winstead shaded the first couple. Will Winstead, your champ at 132 pounds.
Should change his nickname like to Will Trapstead. William Trapstead.
I like that. Coming up next, good look there at the junior, Maddie Lloyd. Young lady from Highlands, North Carolina. A couple hours northeast of the great city of Atlanta. She was a Highlander at high school, at the Highlands High School. Maddie Lloyd getting ready for a 139-pound bout against that fighter, Sam Thompson, the junior from Hughesville, Pennsylvania, an hour west of Wilkes-Barre. Spartan in high school at Hughesville High School. She was the 156-pound wing open champion last year, was Sam Thompson. So Thompson with the blue gloves, Maddie Lloyd with the red. Lloyd, your outstanding boxer last year, also the champion at 132. As a junior Olympic gymnast growing up.
Wow.
And her grandfather was an officer in the United States Navy, was Maddie Lloyd. Good look there at Maddie Lloyd.
Yeah, Maddie literally did like every sport in high school. She's just a unit of athleticism. Also, like many other boxers on the team, another one of those boxers that, you know, she just came to practice one day, just different. And like since then, she's just like, you know, I feel like everybody reaches that point. I have myself, like everybody reaches that point where like it becomes like, you know, just senseless, like punching and fighting, and then you just find your rhythm and you just work with it and it just works for you. And I'm also really excited to see what her and Sam put in this ring these next three rounds.
Maddie Lloyd with the red gloves, Sam Thompson in the blue corner. Fighters circling, you mentioned Maddie Lloyd's sporting background. She was the conference player of the year in both volleyball and basketball as a senior in high school.
That is crazy.
At the Highland School.
Super athletic.
of a calmer beginning to this fifth fight at the Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Both fighters looking to find their spacing, find their angles. Nice right over the top from Matty Lloyd. Thompson responds with the straight punch.
Oh, good right.
This fight at 139 pounds, just a pound under the welterweight beginning of 140. Just trying to time that right hand was Thompson. Lloyd looks like she shrugged it off. The fighters having their moment in the center of the ring. Nice little jab there from Matty Lloyd.
Matty's just a lot more, so much more poised in the ring, especially, you know, now in front of arguably the biggest crowd she'll be in front of other than nationals and regionals. Just a lot of poise and calmness from her. I like to see that.
Yeah, I love the word you use there, poise. Looks like she's almost moving slow, Matty Lloyd, but she's just using that experience, not expending too much energy.
It's very efficient.
10 seconds remaining in the first round. Bit of a
nice body shot.
Feeling out round in round number one. Sam Thompson and Matty Lloyd. That'll be the end of one here at 139 pounds.
I think it's dope to see everybody's like punch mannerisms, because some people scream and yell, some people like hiss like snakes, and other people do like something in between, but both of them hiss, and it sound like if your eyes are closed, it would sound like snakes, like in the ring fighting. But that's dope. I think it's super dope. I was a yeller when I punched.
Does that help you with your timing, or just the sort of reflex that you do, not something that you think about?
Honestly, don't. Maybe it's a placebo effect or something. But I found that when I yelled and punched at the same time, like I would just throw more. Maybe it would seem like I threw more, but it probably did nothing, but I felt like it did something. So
that's all that matters.
Yeah. I definitely would come out of fights less tired because I was just like releasing more of that carbon dioxide.
Ready for round number two between Matty Lloyd, Sam Thompson here at the United States Air Force Academy, 63rd annual Wing Open. On a windy day in Colorado Springs as we get ready for the snow. Nice little right under the armpit from Sam Thompson. Seemed to anger Matty Lloyd, who responds with a combination to the head. Nice left from Thompson. Doesn't seem like it hurt Lloyd.
Yeah, Maddie's just very graceful with all the movements, but she's actually just like moving really fast, but it's just so smooth and silky that it looks a lot slower on camera.
Landed a nice uppercut, did Matty Lloyd, in that last exchange. Five junior. Nice
body shot.
Yep, exactly. Shot around the side of that elbow.
Sam, too, it's just really, really fulfilling to see how they just fit into their own modes that they've worked and practiced to create. Sam has gotten much better about how she executes her punches and, you know, throws more combos.
You mentioned it there, our ringside mics picking up that hiss as the fighters throw the punches. Nice right from Matty Lloyd.
And they both still have like a full year, a whole another season to grow. And like the point that they're at now, like these are, you know, regional and national contenders. And I can only imagine what type of growth they're going to find themselves experiencing as next season progresses.
Yeah, both members of the class of 2022 here at the Academy. Brings an end to round number two. Difficult one so far, perhaps, for the judges to score, but we've got a whole round left. Take a look at some of that action.
Oh, that
beautiful
was nice.
Uppercut,
yeah.
From Matty Lloyd.
That was That was gorgeous. Maddie's been doing a great job of just sneaking that short yet really hard two in there. For her to recycle that and throw an uppercut, that's beautiful.
To be completed in this fight at 139 pounds, Maddie Lloyd, the junior, against her classmate, Sam Thompson. Two very evenly fought rounds. You saw that wonderful uppercut from Maddie Lloyd in the second round, perhaps the best punch of this fight so far. Good look at Maddie Lloyd. She comes out of the corner. Fighters will touch it up. 3rd and final round, Sam Thompson.
Good head movement from Sam.
Looking to find her range, just hasn't been able to unleash that right hand yet. Looks like she's got a Air Force tattoo on that right shoulder blade. My eyes don't deceive me.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Nice little
left.
That was
a good left.
It sure was from Sam Thompson. You could hear that one ringside. Sam Thompson really pushing the pace in this opening stage of the third round. They're circling. Maddie Lloyd just waiting for her moment, perhaps for another uppercut. Nice left from Lloyd. Sam Thompson did a good job to back out of it before that combination could get near. Wild right over the top from Maddie Lloyd connects with Sam Thompson's glove. Nice right there from Lloyd.
Ooh.
Looking more and more for that over the top right hand. There's Lloyd. Nice little left from Sam Thompson. She closes in. 30 seconds remaining in this bout. Our fifth the 63rd annual Wing Open here in Colorado Springs. Pleasure to have you along with us on this windy Wednesday.
Very windy today.
A shot from Lloyd, looks for the right. Sam Thompson hears
good
10
right.
seconds.
Oh, good step through. I was drilling that in practice a lot last year, and it was such an awkward move until we got in the ring.
Fourth fight, going to be a difficult one, I would imagine,
yeah,
for the ringside judges to score.
I think if I was a judge, I'll split that to Maddie. But they're both like really, you know, just really good fighters. And if I was, you know, Coach Baldy or Coach Green, I would probably like, you know, have them fight at different weight classes next year so that they both can go to nationals. But that's a good skill set to bring. Maddie's walkout song was from a Wrangler commercial that I really liked. Johnny Cash is a very good country artist.
If you like it more than the AC/DC we have now ringing through Coon Arena.
Yeah, Johnny Cash is, I don't know, his voice, it just has like a ruggedness. I do like AC/DC though.
That's fair. I'm Rolling Thunder, I'm Pouring Rain, one of the best starts to a rock song of all time.
I agree. I tried to learn electric guitar when I was younger, but I stopped because I kept getting finger cramps, like really bad hand cramps when I was a kid, and I would be a lot really painful, so I stopped. Hopefully I'll pick it back up one day.
See what the PA announcer does here.
Oh yeah, wow. He is a very... He's a very good suspense builder.
He sure is. Maddie Lloyd getting that decision to go her way. She wins at 139 pounds over her classmate, Sam Thompson. So Maddie Lloyd, the 2021 Wing Open champ over Sam Thompson. We'll get ready to move up in weight to the 147-pound class. The welterweight class.
veteran class, Corinna Swift. Corinna Swift was the runner-up last year and is this year's champion. Let's hear it for Corinna Swift.
Walk over being awarded. Got a good look there at Josh Payton. Earns his first wing open title by virtue of a walk over at 139 pounds. Does Payton, another man out of your neck of the woods, sir, in Chicago, Illinois. He went to the Chicago Military Academy. Did Josh Payton, just a sophomore, with his first wing open title as we are ready for a bout in the welterweight division.
This is a classic. Classic song in my years in middle school.
Ayaz Mustafa moving down from 156 last year, the junior from Duluth, Georgia, to Riverside Military Academy, the Eagles in Gainesville, Georgia. Same high school as CeeLo Green. And he will be taking on that young man, Tyler.
This is gonna be an amazing fight.
Tyler Dalzell, sophomore from Doylestown, PA, 15 miles northwest of Trenton. So Dalzell in the blue gloves, great look at him there against Ayaz Mustafa here in the welterweight division, 147 pounds.
Yeah, really excited about this. I think this is going to get my vote for fight of the night.
Ladies and gentlemen, 147 pounds, a junior.
As you hear there,
fighting out of the red corner.
147 pounds.
Mustafa.
As Mustafa, the finalist last year at 147 pounds, semifinalist at 156 back in 2019. Tyler Dalzell. Man from just about three quarters of an hour west of City of Brotherly Love. See how much brotherly love in this fight. Ready for round number one. We are underway.
Man,
Mustafa backing up quickly.
So much skill here.
You can tell already just how quick twitch these fighters are. Mustafa with the confidence, bouncing around. Looking to land that right. Backs
Ooh,
up.
Man.
Dalzell. Nice right there, kind of a clutch from Dalzell.
Shout out to Devin Smith, 20-year boxer that graduated last year. I remember seeing him and Yaz go down like all the time, and you know Yaz just really practiced with him because he used to fight at 56, they used to fight and practice a lot, and a lot of Devin's mannerisms come out and Yaz is fighting, and he just made him his own, and like he has his own style now. He's a very mobile fighter, like easy, like just very athletic in how he moves around.
See the confidence from Mustafa, keeping those hands low when he's got the distance from Dalzell.
And Tyler, I remember our first fight, I think it was at Seattle. That was his first fight traveling to, and just seeing like, you know, how nervous he was and how, you know, how anxious we all get before that first fight to now is just crazy. Like I think if you put his growth on a graph, it's just definitely exponential. And I think, you know, by the time, even at the end of his junior year, he's going to be ridiculously good. I'm really excited about the 23s.
Backs Mustafa up into the corner. He's not bothered at all. He'll just back out there, give us a little twinkle toes. In front of Dalzell. Dalzell with the end of that left hand didn't do much damage to Mustafa. 10 seconds remaining in this first round. Nice little combination from Dalzell. Mustafa got caught in the corner just momentarily. That'll bring an end to round number one. We'll jump back, take a look at some of the action here from the. See, working the body there. Mustafa not causing Dalzell too many issues, and then
that shoulder roll is nice. Nice shoulder work from Dalzell.
Good little combination as well from the young man. Get a good look at him there from Doylestown, Pennsylvania. He was a buck in high school at Central Bucks West. Gazelle getting his instructions from his corner.
I think Tyler's one of those boxers, like, he gets better every fight. Like, every Friday night fight, every sparring session, he learns something from it, he practices it, and he applies it in the very next fight. And even I saw him in him and Ayaz fight in the last Friday night fight, and he just looked like a completely different fighter from then, and that was like 2 weeks ago.
Rip-roaring start to the second round here in Colorado Springs. Both fighters exchanging as Mustafa went into the ropes and bounced quickly back out, trying to land the combination. Dalzell trying to catch him on the way out. Nice left hand from Mustafa. Neither fighter taking too much punishment so far in this bout. Dalzell just pulling back there with the left hand.
This is such a good fight. There's so much skill and, like, just boxing instinct. You get to a point where, like, once you apply that strategy and, like, you just become used to being in your rhythm, you start to have somewhat of an instinct in the ring. And, like, your body just moves in a certain direction without you having to think about it much. And I see this a lot in this fight.
Into the corner now is Mustafa. Dalzell looking to apply the pressure. And he spins around, turns the tables on Tyler Dalzell. Fighters will establish back to the center of the ring. Just taken down to about 30 seconds remaining here in round number two of this bout. Welterweight, 147 pounds. Sort of slowing things down before they start again. Clinch initiated from Mustafa. Listening to the referee's instructions to break, both fighters do so. Nice left from Mustafa as he was fading away into the corner. Dalzell looking to land one last big punch, was able to get a right, then a left. And that'll bring an end to round number two. Mustafa with the smile as he walks back to his corner and acknowledges the crowd. Take a look at some of the highlights from that.
Wow.
Second 2 minute round.
Both of them are having fun in there too. They both, I think it definitely is a skills boost when you stop seeing a fight or just a big bout as like something intimidating and as something scary, and you see it as an opportunity to have fun and just like let your style just show. And I think they both see it like that now. And, you know, from this point on, it's just upward motion and just so much growth. Because they both still have, you know, 1 and 2, year-long opportunities to just grow. So I'm really excited to see the point they hit at their senior year at Nationals. Hopefully with the belt wrapped around their waist.
Hopefully we can get back to some semblance of normalcy next year.
Man, I hope so.
The left hand from Mustafa beginning the third round, championship round here. The 63rd annual wing open in Colorado Springs.
Very good head movement from Dawson. That shoulder roll is really his bread and butter.
Lovely left hand from Mustafa as he was pulling away there.
Wow, very good. That was really hard to do, to step through and like duck and do a step back at the same time. That's a very athletic move.
Yeah, wonderful body control from both fighters. You see the athleticism of Mustafa. He tries that low step once again. Fighters will clinch, they'll break per the referee's instruction.
Dalzell is just sticking it right in there with the punches.
Dalzell got a tremendous motor. Going toe-to-toe here with Ayaz Mustafa. Mustafa with the red gloves. Dalzell with the blue. Inside of a minute remaining in this fight. Fight at 147 pounds. A little bit of the sting taken out of some of these Mustafa punches lately. Both fighters breathing heavily in Colorado Springs.
Man, this is definitely my vote for fight of the night. Fight of the night, for sure.
Both fighters looking to land that key shot. 15 seconds remaining. Nice little body shot from Mustafa. Dalzell responds with one of his own. 10 seconds. Inside of 10 seconds now. Nice right from Dalzell.
Oh, man, that was an amazing, amazing fight.
A wonderful contest here at 147 pounds. Take a look at some of the action there from round number three. Dalzell pushing Mustafa into the corner. Nice little step, you mentioned it, in live time from Mustafa to wriggle out of that situation. And both fighters averse to getting into the clinch. Mustafa just showing the sportsmanship, sharing a laugh with the referee. It's a well-refereed fight as well, and we will see what the PA announcer has in store for us with his long pause before announcing the winner of this bout at 147 pounds. Tyler Dalzell on your left, young man from Doylestown, PA. I ask Mustafa on your right as you look at home from Duluth, Georgia.
Oh, man.
Wow.
I can't say I'm very surprised, man. It was a really, really, really good fight. Like I would have been satisfied either way. Like if Yaz won, or if Tyler won. Yaz won their last fight, so this is good. This is rivalry. This is what we need, because they're both gonna make each other better. That's exactly what, you know, needs to happen.
Tremendous fight, as you call during their walkouts. Get ready for a fight at 156 pounds. It's a shade over super welterweight. That is Annalise Holland, the senior from Olathe, Kansas, southwestern part of the greater Kansas City area. She went to Olathe North High School, the Eagles. Should be fighting at 156 pounds. Will be taking on that young woman, Mac Lucas, the freshman from Upton, Massachusetts, 3/4 of an hour west of Boston, 30 minutes southeast of Worcester. Phillips Academy in Andover, Massachusetts, the big blue Phillips Academy did Mac Lucas. So Mac Lucas, the freshman, Annalise Holland, the senior, fight here at 156 pounds. Our seventh fight of the evening at Clune Arena in the 63rd annual Wing Open.
With 156 pounds, female, a senior from Squadron 19,
Annalise Holland.
Annalise Holland.
Senior from just east of us here against the freshman. Lucas from Upton, Massachusetts. See the height advantage for Lucas. A slight height advantage, but it's there.
Looks calm. I'm excited to see what they do.
156 pound fight. Good exchange early. Fighters. Great intensity coming out of their corners. A couple swings over the top there from Annalise Holland, the senior.
It's also another right shoulder blade tat as well.
Seen a lot of those Could easily match that one out with a Air Force tattoo on the left shoulder blade.
Yeah.
Something for the future. Nice couple of rights there from Holland. Really nice right from Mac Lucas.
I think they both joined the team this last year in August, and you know, just seeing all the tools that they have that they're using now is pretty crazy. It just the growth is so significant.
It's gonna be great to follow the career of Mac Lucas, class of 2024. So she's got a while here at the Air Force Academy. Referee just asking for hands to stay up. You also see that tattoo on the inside of the left bicep of Lucas.
A good Lucas tattoo placement on this team.
Fighters exchange. Good fight so far. Ticking down toward 10 seconds remaining here in the first round. Nice right from Annalise Holland. There is the warning for 10 seconds. Nice left from Holland as well. Just backs up Lucas. Really good all action first round.
That's good.
Very good start to that fight here at 156 on the women's side. As we
hopefully the corner ladies in Lucas's corner try to straighten that two out, because if she straightens it, as you can see, she throws the two a lot and it tends to hit the backside of the helmet, but if she just straightened it out, it would go right through the gloves. So hopefully she uses that these next couple rounds. And relax a little bit more. You can see it in the elbows. But, you know, this is a stellar performance to be a freshman at the Wing Open. That's a lot of pressure. And that's something where I didn't make it to the semifinals my freshman year. So to see them here already as freshmen, that's a really good indication of, you know, skill and lots of potential.
And you mentioned the success for this program potentially going forward. We've seen a lot of underclassmen already here on this windy Wednesday evening in Colorado Springs. Get ready for the second round. We are underway. Annalise Holland in the red gloves, Mac Lucas in the blue. Freshman is Lucas against the senior in Holland. Holland with the left through that defensive guard.
I think Lucas will see a lot more success with just straight punches. And that's one thing that I've learned as my freshman year. My problem was going in, like, I would throw punches and just let my feet come with me. And at the end of my combo, I would be giving the other person a hug when I had tons more reach than them. So if she stayed at her distance and, you know, just threw her straight, as simple as those punches may seem, they are probably the most efficient and powerful punches in the game. So if she can just make that one and two and possibly the three her bread and butter, then she's going to see a lot of success. But, you know, she has three years of endless opportunity to just, you know, create her game and see success from it. And I'm excited to see that.
And is that something you learned from a combination of experience and coaching?
Yes, definitely. And just some hard lessons. You know, I caught a couple hard punches just fighting how I used to fight. And, you know, I just realized that staying long and staying at a distance that you can reach but your opponent can't is such a nice way to fight, because you can punch and not get punched. So, yeah. But she has very good punch volume, lots of good conditioning. I was at practice with them on last Thursday, and we were running sprints, and she was one of the fastest. So I'm glad to see that play out in the ring today.
Taking down toward 10 seconds remaining in the second round. Annalise Holland, Mac Lucas. Neither fighter been hurt too badly in this fight, but both fighters exchanging. Nice little end to the second round. So we'll get ready for round number three here at the 63rd annual Wing Open. Great look at Mac Lucas as we take a little jog back to some of the action in that second round. Nice combo there from Lucas, the freshman out of Massachusetts. And then nice left followed by the right. Just catching toward the back of that helmet from Annalise Holland, the senior from the state of Kansas. Both fighters well-deserved break before the start of the third and final round. Our first fight at 156. And we'll see Alan Manzo and Nicholas Nakayoka in the next fight. But before that, we've got one more round of boxing here between Annalise Holland and Mac Lucas.
If I'm not mistaken, this is their first official fight because they haven't had any other fights this season. So this is their first time in front of all these people, in front of the crowd, and you know the entire environment. And they're handling it really well, really, really well.
The bright lights of Clune Arena. Nice little left from Holland, but a good response from Lucas. Really tough fighter is the freshman Lucas. Good exchange from both fighters, knowing they've got to make an impression on the judges' scorecard in the third round. Ducking out of the way of that one was Lucas, but firing again is Holland. Slow down for a minute after some relentless action to start this first minute of the third round. Good timing there from Lucas to land a couple toward the top of the head of Annalise Holland. Catches Holland up against the ropes. Conditioning a real factor in this fight now, inside of a minute remaining.
Mac has a lot of gas to, you know, just keep punching. To punch that much all three rounds is a great starting point as a freshman.
Got a wonderful athletic career in front of her here at the academy. Right hand from Lucas, sort of half lands. Holland backs up, throws a right of her own. 30 seconds remaining in this fight. Back and forth action, senior versus a freshman. Fighters breathing hard, looking to make a real impression. Nice left down the middle from Annalise Holland.
Man, I can just feel the fatigue.
Yeah, both these fighters breathing heavy as we flirt with 7,000 feet here at Clune Arena.
Going.
Wonderful end to that fight.
That was wonderful.
Yeah, that was a really strong end to what was a very good fight between Mac Lucas. You see her right there and Annalise Holland with the red gloves. Take a look at some of the action from the third round.
She has a lot of potential.
Fantastic fight between the upperclassmen and the freshmen. Annalise Holland, the senior, Mac Lucas, the freshman. We'll pause for the judges' scorecard in just a moment. Pause from the PA announcer, certainly stealing the show so far, the 63rd annual Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Great look at Annalise Holland. Fantastic contest that she fought against Mac Lucas. And we'll see which way the judges decide to go after this one. I haven't seen any fighters hit the floor so far this evening in Colorado Springs. '21 Wing Open champ at 156 pounds, the senior Annalise Holland. What a fantastic fight. Mac Lucas has a lot to be
so
proud of
potential.
And a lot to look forward to here at the United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs.
By senior year, she is going to be one tough cookie. Would not want to get in the ring with her.
Look forward to our second fight at 156 pounds in the middleweight division. Coming out first out of the red corner, Alan Monto. Young man who calls Inglewood, California home. Went to high school in Victorville. Silverado High School. Alan Monto. He will be facing off against a sophomore, Nicholas Nakayoka. Young man from Honolulu, Hawaii. There he is. Went to Tanahu School, the Buff and Blue in high school. He will be in blue this evening. The Wing Open finalist at this very same middleweight, 156 pounds in the 2020 Wing Open. Good look at Nakayoka. There is Alan Monto.
Man, Monto has made, he when he first came on the team, he was at 185. And to see him drop all the way down to 156 is crazy. And now he's just a action figure. Arms, man. Wow.
Again, two fighters not missing any days in the weight room.
Nicholas Nakayoka.
Great sportsmanship. Like, you can see that everybody on the team are like friends, and that makes it so much easier to fight.
There's a ton of respect. We've seen that all evening long. We're ready here for this middleweight bout, 156 pounds, a junior against a sophomore. Quick early start from Monto. Referee going to slow things down. Back underway. Both fighters with some of that early nervous energy under the lights here at Clune Arena. Quick combinations from Nakayoka.
Man, the trap work on this team is unmatched.
How are your lat pull downs?
Man, they must pull down cars, or it can't be the weights that are on a bar. It has to be something more.
Beautiful right from Monto.
Monzo's also made his own style too. Just, you know, seeing he's really grinded for every part of what's happening tonight, and I know this means a lot for him too, because this is what he's been working for. And I know, you know, when he gets to that national arena next year, hopefully he's going to be that much prouder, because he works really hard. So does Nicholas Nakayoka too.
Yeah, you mentioned the weight loss for Monto.
Yeah, 40 or, you know, 30-ish pounds, or that is a lot of weight to lose, and it takes so much intention and accountability, and he did it. I think he's the only out of my 4 years on the team, I haven't seen anybody else drop down as far as he has. I think he's he definitely is a very hard worker, and when he puts his mind to it, he can really do anything he wants, especially in the ring.
Taken down toward just 10 seconds remaining in this small action first round. Started with a real flurry. Calm down a little bit as we tick down toward the end. Nice little combo from Nakayoka. And that should be the end of round one. And it is here in Colorado Springs, the 156-pound middleweight division. The 63rd annual Wing Open. Take a look at some of that action from the first. Nice little right hand there to the temple from Nakayoka. Such a strong fighter. Monto just backing up his opponent. Takes a bit of a left on the way out. Take a good look there at the young man from Honolulu, Hawaii. Another man who fancies a little bit of spear fishing when he's home for the holidays is Nicholas Nakayoka.
Yeah, me and fishing don't get along. I remember I was like 10, And I would spend 10 minutes just like just waiting, just patiently waiting, and the fish wouldn't come to my pole, and they went to my brother's. So I cried and threw the fishing rod and just went home. But hopefully I'll pick it back up.
Start of round number two. Fighters engaged early and then get their space from each other. Nakayoka in the blue gloves, Manzo in red. Referee asks them to break. Fighters respect the commands. Nice left from Nakayoka. Almost halfway through this fight.
I'm almost positive those are bowling balls instead of shoulders on Manzo. Nakaoka has grown a lot too from last year to now. It's very poised and a lot more calm in there.
Was a judoka in high school, was Nakaoka. 3-year captain of the varsity judo team.
Wow.
Also won state title in the great state of Hawaii on the soccer field.
I think Nakaoka's like Instagram story could be on the Discovery Travel Channel, because if down the street from his house is like a cliff to the ocean, and Hawaii is just so beautiful. I need to visit one day. Hopefully do some spear fishing.
You know who to ask. You're gonna pick up the spear fishing out in the 808.
Yeah, definitely need some tips.
Kicking down toward 10 seconds remaining in this second round. Middleweight bout at 156 pounds.
That was a nice hug.
Both fighters seem like they're already thinking ahead to round number three. That's the bell for the end of two. Good look there at Nicholas Nakayoka.
I think Nakayoka is doing a really good job of picking him apart as he comes in. Like keeping those twos like nice and short and straight and just catching Manzo on the way in. But also Manzo's doing a good job of like keeping the pressure high, moving his head and, you know, looking for openings on a taller fighter.
Manzo getting his instructions, refusing the chair in the corner is Alan Manzo.
Manzo has some stone cold hands for sure.
Young man who went to high school in Victorville, California, about an hour and a half or so, depending on traffic, northeast of the City of Angels. We are ready for round number three in Colorado Springs. Alan Manzo, great look at him there. Got a bit of an abrasion on that left shoulder. Not that his shoulder would know it, against Nicholas Nakayoka.
Can't even feel it because it's actually a rock with some brown paint on it. Or something.
Great start to the third round. Fighters exchanging punches with intent.
Very intentional boxing here.
Manzo just touches with the left jab. Fighters giving each other space, eyeing each other up. Nice left there from Nakayoka.
Ooh. Hit him so hard, made him spin around.
Kicking down toward just a minute remaining in this fight started. All guns, no pun, blazing here. And then it's kind of cooled off a little bit in the second. A great start to the third. Inside of a minute remaining. In this round, Nicholas Nakayoka, Alan Manzo. Manzo sort of half through that last left jab. Fighters will clinch. Wait for referee. They'll break. Half a minute remaining in this fight. It's the 63rd annual Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Pleasure to have you along with us.
think they gotta, you know, get it, pick up the pace here. But that was a good left. Should have capitalized off that.
Yeah, might want to make an impression with the judges. This will be the 10-second warning. Little right under the elbow there from Monzo. Monzo goes right back to that spot, not bothering Nakayoka. That'll be the end.
Good
back
fight.
And forth fight. Once again, great sportsmanship here at the United States Air Force Academy between Nicholas Nakayoka and Alan Monzo.
Yeah, Monzo's been in the game for a minute. He was a prior in the Air Force. I went to the prep school with folks like J Love, and you know, he's came a long way to such a long journey, and I think that's part of why he was able to cut so much weight. He's just in a much more mature spot, has a lot of dedication and ambition, and you can see it in everything about him. Like, he really wants this, and he really believes that, you know, he has everything it takes to get that belt at the end of your 4 years.
Going to be a tight decision here by the judges. Who would you favor after that fight?
Man, I think Nakayoka threw a lot of punches that, you know, when Monzo was coming in on the inside, if I had to choose, because Monzo kept that pressure going, I would give a split to Monzo. This is one of those fights where it can go either way. Just both super good fighters.
We rate the judges' scorecard.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner.
Oh man, the suspense.
Out of the red corner, Alan Monzo!
Alan Monzo, the junior from California. Your 2021 Wing Open champ at 156 pounds over Nicholas Nakayoka. Fantastic fight as we get ready for a little action at 165, just under the super middleweight classification. Between Yamani Nesmith, the junior from Union, New Jersey, just about 8 minutes west of Newark International Airport, into Union Catholic Regional High School, the Vikings, in Scotch Plains, New Jersey. She will be taking on young lady from the basketball team, Malia Marlette, fighter sophomore out of Aurora, Colorado, with a Wolf in high school with Grandview. Played a couple games, 18 minutes this year for the women's basketball team, Malia Marlette, against Yamani Nesmith. Nesmith, the 2020 Wing Open champion, right here at 165 pounds. She's got the experience against Marlette.
Both ex-basketball players. So I wonder if there's like an extra level of spunk and beef in this rivalry.
Attempted the prep school did. Nesmith, listening to the referee's instructions. We're just about to get underway here at 165. Ninth fight of the evening here at the 63rd annual Wing Open in Colorado Springs. And we are underway. Marlette Nesmith. Nesmith in the red gloves, Marlette in the blue.
Wow, good head movement.
Marlette ducked right out of that right hand from Nesmith. Nesmith doing the same, throwing as she backs up. Nice left there from Leah Marlette.
You can just see the athleticism transfer from basketball to just how they move. It's very quick twitch.
can't teach what they've learned on the court, especially with that those quick feet, as you mentioned. Marlette, a sophomore, Nesmith, a junior. Marlette from just up the road in Aurora, Colorado.
Imani's punch complexity is just doubled since her early years on the team too. She's throwing a lot more complex punches and stringing a lot more complicated combos together, and she's finding that they land a lot more. It's really good. Glad to see it.
Fighters not willing to go into the corner. They'll move back to the center of the ring. Trying to land that combination was Aaliyah Marlette. Just backs out of it once again. Nesmith controls the center of the ring for now. 10 seconds remaining here in the first round at 165 pounds. It's going to be our
that was nice.
Final women's bout of the evening. That'll bring an end to the first round.
Marlette has a really good head movement. I think if I'm not mistaken, I haven't seen her on the team outside of this year. And that head movement is definitely advanced, and it's a great starting point for her to work on and just fine tune. Great head movement. That was the one slip too is very, very difficult combo. For somebody that's just starting out, she catches on quickly. Lots of potential, especially from the women's side as wing open. Lots of potential, I see.
Great look at Imani Nesmith there, the junior from New Jersey. Getting her instructions from the corner. Majoring in computer science here
at
the United States Air Force Academy.
Don't see any tattoos this fight, but I do see very, very well, very good traps on Marlette. Not lots of high trap definition on the team this year. We take pride in that because it shows so well on the boxing uniforms.
Now it all makes sense.
Yeah. If you have to work on one muscle group, it'll just be the traps.
Nesmith. Early flurry that Marlette's able to easily step away from, just not able to find her range yet, is Aaliyah Marlette. See that right hand left a little bit short. Both of these fighters, negligible difference in height, perhaps just shaded by Aaliyah Marlette by an inch or two.
Marlette just has to carry a little bit more fundamentals with her punches. Very good starting point though. She's such an athlete, and that's easy to work with, but she just has to remember to move her feet forward on the jab, because the jab, although it's meant to land, it's also meant to close distance and set up for the twos and the threes and the fours. And she isn't stepping with her jab, which is why her right hand fell short. And she was leaning over off balance. But very, very athletic nonetheless.
As you said, perhaps a good starting point for Marlette, just a sophomore here at the academy. Nice left there. Nesmith felt that one a little bit. Nesmith doing a good job staying out of the range of Marlette. Backed Marlette up there with a strong shot right down the middle. Ever closer toward 10 seconds remaining in this second round of this 165-pound fight. Our final fight on the women's side this evening. Nice right from Marlette. Counter right from Nesmith. And that should be just about that in the second round. There will be the bell right on cue. We'll take a look back at some of that action from the second. Right here. Nice little combo from Imani Nesmith. Marlette doing a good job backing away, but she caught a couple there from Nesmith. Nice right from Marlette, perhaps her best punch of the night. Get a good look at the corner of Imani Nesmith.
Yeah. Imani also has, you know, it's a long journey. This is her fifth year here. Went to the prep school with the J-Love as well. And it's interesting to see the demeanor difference between people that went to the prep school, you know, and came here directly. It's different breed of people. I wish I went to the prep school. Real fun place.
Located here on base at the Air Force Academy, just a little bit south of the Air Force Academy, on the second largest college campus in the United States of America, here in Colorado Springs. Fighters feeling each other out early doors in the third round. Marlette once again looking for that right. She had some success with that in the second. Ducks out of that flurry from Nesmith.
Great head. She just high mobility. That's really, really good. Just a token of athleticism.
Just going to say that word, Leah Marlette. No stranger to performing here at Kloon Arena. Nice right from Marlette. Good attacking boxing from Imani Nesmith. Quick combo from Nesmith, just lacking the power to hurt Marlette.
This is also Imani's, I think this is her first fight of the year as well, just because the season's been so funky with COVID. Lots of basketball-like mobility that we just saw.
Yeah, quick with their feet, quick around the corners as well. Both of these fighters. Nesmith pushing the pace. Last couple exchanges. The junior from Union, New Jersey. Seconds remaining in this bout, back and forth bout. Nice right from Nesmith. And again,
ooh.
Marlette goes headhunting, trying to land a right of her own. Lands a nice left and then a right. Good combination there from Aaliyah Marlette to finish that fight.
Yeah, I think it's been a couple of times when I've been in the ring and I've just been so tired and delirious after round three that, like, I forget to, like, shake the other person's hand or something, and, like, I just forget how to shake hands. So I've missed so many handshakes that were put in my direction at the end of fights because I was just so tired. But great fight. Good athleticism from Marlette. Lots of potential. Two more years to hone and sculpt that mold that she wants to fill. And I have no doubt that, you know, when she's at the point that our Imani is at now, she'll be a tough opponent. Hopefully she likes to score a little bit more than basketball.
Sportsmanship shown there between these two fighters. We await the judges' scorecard as we have for every other fight here tonight at the 63rd annual Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Aaliyah Marlette on the left of your screen, wearing blue. Imani Nesmith in the silver and black on the right-hand side as you watch at home. Pleasure to have you along with us here on a Wednesday evening from Colorado Springs, Kloon Arena.
Ladies and gentlemen,
go to the card.
165-pound your winner. Red corner.
And it'll go to Imani Nesmith. She's the victor at 165 pounds, your 2021 Wing Open champion. Good fight from Aaliyah Marlette. As we get ready to move across to the men at 165 pounds. Checking in first will be the sophomore out of Bethesda, Maryland, went to St. John High School in Washington, D.C., Alan Long.
legendary walkout song from arguably the greatest Japanese cartoon of all time, Cowboy Bebop. Great song.
Long getting jazzed up here at Kuhn Arena. He was a finalist last year's ring open at the very same weight. 165 pounds in the blue corner. Young man from Laurel, Maryland. Sid Reyes, about halfway between Baltimore and D.C. on I-95. With a stag in high school in Hyattsville, Maryland, at DeMatha Catholic, Prince George's County. So Sid Reyes, great look at him there against Alan Long here at 165 pounds for the men. Sid Reyes is... paternal grandfather served in the Marines, and paternal grandfather served in the United States Navy. Another fighter that comes from a military background. Good look there at Alan Long. Both of these fighters are sophomores. Both from the great state of Maryland. Both getting their instructions. You see Long just shading the height advantage. He's about 6'1". Sid Reyes goes 5'10". And we are underway, round number one, here at the 63rd annual Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Pleasure to have you along with us. We are ringside. I'm Roland Vargas, joined by Canadian Clifton Smith, two-time Wing Open champ in his own right at 175 pounds. We'll get to see that division coming up next, but for now, we must make do with the 165-pounder Sid Reyes in the blue gloves, Alan Long in red. The fighter showed a lot of early energy to start this one. It's cooled off just a little bit. Alan Long backs Reyes up with a strong right hand. Lengthy, got a long reach, does Alan Long, the sophomore from Bethesda. Like I mentioned earlier, spent his high school days in our nation's capital at St. John's High School. Looking for that uppercut was long, but Reyes, keen to that, backed out of it well in advance. Left again from Alan Long using his reach advantage. Beautiful right, that floors wow. Sid Reyes. Beautiful shot from Alan Long.
Wow.
What a quick right hand that was from Alan Long.
It's all in the traps.
Right down the pipe, put Sid Reyes on his backside. First fighter we've seen hit the canvas so far this evening. Another strong right from Alan Long, good heart from Sid Reyes. And that'll be the end of round number one. That certainly belonged to the young man in the red gloves, Alan Long. Take a look at that first round. Looking for that uppercut was Long. And then a beautiful right hand there. That stung Sid Reyes. But it was the right just a little bit later in the round that put Reyes down, there it is, straight right, caught the bottom of the chin. Nowhere that Sid Reyes could go except straight down. Beautiful display of boxing in that first round from Alan Long.
That was a crazy right hand. And you can tell he's having fun in there too. Sid Reyes is also very good. All the freshmen that have, you know, joined the team thus far have been, or all the freshmen and sophomores, class of 2023, sorry, have been really good and like just have tons of potential. Tons of potential.
Great look at Alan Long. We are ready for round number two. Alan Long looking to capitalize on that stellar first round that he had. That reach advantage, we talked about it. He was a couple inches taller than Sid Reyes. Reyes, though, looking to give as good as he got in that first round. Here in the second, he backs Long up, buckled the knees a little bit of Alan Long. Nice punch from Sid Reyes. It's been an all-action fight so far.
Man.
Nice right hand from Long.
Shout out to Levi Raitt, too. Alan Long and Levi Raitt sparred and fought a lot last year during the season. And I think, like, it's just one of those situations where you fight. You know, we've all had that person that we got in the ring with that we kind of dreaded. And, like, that was better than us. But, you know, in hindsight, that just made us so much of a better fighter.
Standing count for Sid Reyes after a nice left from Alan Long. Just going to ask for those gloves to be restrapped. 51 seconds remaining here in the second round at 165 pounds. Just under the light heavy, just above middleweight. Here we are at 165. We are ready to go. Inside of a minute remaining here in the second round. Both fighters have endured some damage in this fight. Sid Reyes was sent down to the canvas in the first round. Alan Long had his knees given an almighty wobble here in the second. Nice punch from Sid Reyes. Reyes looking to time the right hand. That was a strong shot. We could hear that one ringside. Beautiful position we have here at Clune Arena.
Allen with the Nike Elite socks. I think that definitely adds to the punch power.
Another strong right hand from Alan Long and another count for Sid Reyes. And that's going to be it. That is going to be a win for Alan Long. Stopping the fight is the referee. Good refereeing, you've got to say. Sid Reyes just not able to hang with the length and the power of Alan Long. Tremendous fight from both fighters. We've said that time and time again here this evening in Colorado Springs. Take a look at, there was Alan Long. That was the nice shot from Sid Reyes that wobbled the legs of Long. But in the end, just too much from the sophomore from Bethesda. Just wore down.
Good right.
A man from Laurel, Maryland. Beautiful right hand. That was the end. Referee stepped in, called an end of it. Wing Open Championship goes to that young man, Alan Long.
Ladies and gentlemen, women by referee stop contest. Out of the ring corner, Alan Long.
So last year's finalist at 165. This year's 2021 Wing Open champ at the very same weight, defeating Sid Reyes. Great effort from Reyes, just superior punching power in the end from Alan Long. Now we'll move up to a division that you, sir, know very well, 175 pound weight class. Introducing first a young man from one of the great cities in this country, Miami, Florida, went to Everglades High School, the Gators of Everglades High School, Luke Pilianski, the senior.
Yes, sir, Luke Pilianski. Excited to see what he puts together in the ring today.
Two-time Wing Open finalist, both at this very weight of 175 pounds. And he will be squaring off against a freshman from Ackworth, Georgia, just northwest of Atlanta, through Marietta, Joe Wilson. Waiting to announce Wilson. There he is, right on cue. He was a Buccaneer in high school, at Allatoona High School. Joe Wilson, the freshman, stands 5'11". Fun fact, he was born in Vietnam.
Let's go. I always wanted to travel to Vietnam. I hear the coast is beautiful.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen,
one of the real pearls of Southeast Asia. Good look at Luke Kilianski, the senior. Got a couple inches on Joe Wilson, 6'2". This is Luke Kilianski, as we said, out of Miami, Florida.
A freshman of Squadron 10, Joe Wilson.
There is Joe Wilson. You can see that slight height advantage for Kilianski as the two fighters square off. Another fighter who was prior enlisted, Joe Wilson. He was stationed at Cannon Air Force Base in the Land of Enchantment. Rip-roaring start to this fight. Both fighters landing some heavy shots.
Yeah, I think Wilson's one of his biggest strategies is that right hand. So I think Luke needs to keep that left hand up and just stick to, you know, those straight ones and twos instead of fighting Joe Wilson's game. But we'll see.
Both fighters not afraid to get up close and personal. Wilson's landed a couple of big shots. He takes one there from Kilianski. A tremendous start to this fight we have here, the 63rd annual Wing Open in Colorado Springs. Nice combination from Wilson. Just a freshman, Joe Wilson. A lot of feinting and ducking and diving is Wilson. Strong shot backed Luke Kilianski up. Freshman looking to make an impression on the senior, Kilianski. Kilianski with the slight reach advantage. Tremendous first round, first minute of the first round. That was here at Clune Arena.
Good right hand.
Second to last fight of the evening. What's been a fabulous Wing Open this year. Stay in there. 10 seconds just about remaining. There it is. Here in the first, nice right hand from Joe Wilson. Nice right hand again from Wilson. And that'll be the end to just a tremendous first round here in Colorado Springs. Take a look at some of the action from the first. Joe Wilson came out firing to start that fight. Caught Kilianski a couple times. Kilianski doing a good job just backing up and then hitting Joe Wilson with a couple of really strong rights of his own. Nice combination there just to the end of the chin of Joe Wilson. Wonderful first round of this fight. Strong right. Saw there from Wilson sort of angered Kilianski. He came back at the younger fighter. Senior, Miami, Florida's Luke Kilianski, two-time Wing Open finalist here at 175 pounds. A man you know all too well, sir. You fought against him a couple times in this weight class.
Yeah, very tough. They're just tough cookie all around. Just take all of the punches you throw in and throw them right back. Doesn't give up. Just needs to get that left hand up because Joe is looking to land that overhand right hand.
Joe Wilson acquitting himself awfully well in that first round against the more experienced fighter, Kilianski. A little bit of a more tepid start to the second round.
Yeah, Joe is looking for that right.
You can see him loading that one up.
This is another one of those fights where it's just advantageous to just throw the straight one and two and, you know, keep your movement well. Because how Joe comes in, he comes in hands open and, you know, not the most guarded, so a straight two from Luca will stop that.
Minute left in the second round. Wind being taken out of the sails of both fighters after just a rip-roaring back and forth first.
Good right.
Yeah, really nice right from Kilianski. They're starting to breathe hard. Doesn't stop the right coming in from Joe Wilson. As we said, prior enlisted, also attended the prep school. Just a fabulous story growing up in Georgia, being born in Vietnam. And that'll be the end of the second round. Take a look back at some of the action. See some of the blood there on the right shoulder from the face of Kilianski on Joe Wilson's right shoulder. Nice little combination, great right hand. You called it in live time from Luke Kilianski.
Man, the bloody nose is such a trophy in the fight, because whether you win or lose, you look like you got beat up, but it's okay. I always thought fighting with a bloody nose is an advantage, because in the fights where you don't bleed, you're a lot less tired than you would be.
Corner working overtime on Luke Kilianski as we get ready for the championship round here at Clune Arena, the United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs. On a blustery Wednesday, ahead of a massive snowstorm. It's going to play havoc with our soccer schedule at the Academy.
Just got to keep that left hand up, and that'll take away, you know, 50% of Joe's strategy there. It's really a game of chess. After you catch on to what the opponent is throwing, you can, you know, exploit that or stop it and see how they react and create a game of your own.
Nice. Couple punches there landed from Kilianski.
Good straight punches from Luke.
Nice right from Joe Wilson once again. Loves that right hand. Just young Joe Wilson. Good exchange. Got just about a shade over a minute remaining in this fight. Started just tremendously well here between these two fighters at 175 pounds. They sit next to the two-time defending winning open champion at that very weight class.
Man, it was a fun two appearances. Good right.
Yeah, caught on the way out was Joe Wilson, just one move too many. Kilianski with the nice right hand, as you said.
Kind of see the consequences of that first round coming to play itself out here in the third.
Nice right again from Kilianski. Joe Wilson, both fighters breathing heavy. 15 seconds remaining in this bout.
Straight punches are going to be that Luke's best friend in his last 10 seconds. There you go.
Right on cue. You called it, sir, as Joe Wilson goes headhunting, trying to make an impression on the judges' scorecard. End of just a tremendous fight at 175 pounds.
Good fight.
Good look at Luke Kilianski. Take a look at some of the moments that stood out from the third round. Shout out, as always, to our world-class Falcon Vision crew working late on a Wednesday night in Clune Arena. Nice right from Joe Wilson. And we will, once again, as we've done for every fight except one, await the judges' scorecard to determine your 2021 Wing Open champ, this time at 175 pounds on our second to last fight of the evening. Just waiting on the judges' scorecard as our director gives me some light-natured ribbing about an important job interview that I have coming up on Friday. What a fight that was between Joe Wilson in the blue and Luke Kilianski in the silver and black.
Fighting a 175-pound male bout.
Oh man.
Red
wow, what a suspenseful sentence.
One of the best PA guys I've heard in a long time. Luke Kilianski, he is your 2021 Wing Open champ at 175 pounds, the senior from Miami, Florida. Luke Kilianski victorious
well
over
deserved.
Joe Wilson.
Very well deserved. I know he wanted that.
Our final fight of the night. This man, the sophomore Walker Morris from Middlebury, Connecticut.
Very excited about this one.
Fighting at 195 pounds. Last year's Wing Open champ at 185 was Walker Morris. He was a Panther in high school in Southbury, Connecticut with Pomparog High School. He will be taking on freshman that we get to see tonight, Antonio Cruz, young man from Abilene, Texas. He was a Cougar at Cooper High School, member of Cadet Squadron 3. So it'll be a freshman versus a sophomore in our final fight of the 63rd annual Wing Open from the United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs.
Very excited to see how Walker has grown from such a good spot last year.
It's
a very great fighter.
195 pounds. Out of the record, last year's 185-pound champion.
As we said, last year's champ at 185 in the Wing Open.
Walker
Morris. Did a little teaching in high school of the mixed martial arts and self-defense variety.
Squadron 3, Antonio.
Freshman Antonio Cruz, Abilene, Texas. Another fighter who attended the prep school here, did Antonio Cruz. And we are ready for our final bout of the night. Fighters touch gloves and we are underway. Little reach advantage perhaps for Morris, but as I say that, Antonio Cruz listed at 6'3 on our stat sheet. Nice little combination though from Walker Morris. And he floors Antonio Cruz right out of the gate.
That is crazy, man. Yeah, Walker's definitely, I've been practicing with the team a little bit this past season, and Walker's been my favorite person to spar for sure.
Another quick right hand from
Walker
Morris, and that is going to be a quick fire into it.
That was 40 seconds.
It sure was. Felt like it was even quicker than that. Walker Morris with the win in the final fight of the night over the freshman Antonio Cruz. Walker Morris rounds out the 63rd annual Wing Open with a win.
It's all
over
all in the trash. And Walker has on the vintage Air Force Boxing Adidas edition shoes. Very powerful artifact there. Proven to increase your boxing skills by 100-fold. Wow, what a fall.
Yeah, I just had nowhere to go. Antonio Cruz, he's got that communication between his head and his feet taken away from him by the punching power of Walker Morris. Walker Morris, the winner at 195 pounds.
Out of the red corner, Walker Morris,
young man from Middlebury, Connecticut. He's the victor over the freshman. We'll see more going forward from both of these fighters. Antonio Cruz got three more years in front of him. Walker Morris, only a sophomore himself. But Walker Morris, he wins at 195 pounds. We'll wait here for our award of the outstanding boxer of the night. We'll go through the winners. Noah Sherman, he was victorious at 119. Lawrence Barrett the winner at 125. Sharina Staten, she won at 132, followed by Will Winstead at the same weight class. And then Maddie Lloyd, she won at 139 pounds. Tyler Dalzell, our champ at 147. Annalise Holland won at 156. Alan Monzo also at 156. Yamani Nesmith victorious over Leah Marlette at 165. Alan Long then beating Sid Reyes at 165. Luke Kilianski, your 175-pound champ, and as we just saw, Walker Morris winning at 195 over Antonio Cruz. Our boxers take to the arena. Walker Morris there showing off that vertical as he skips himself back into the ring as you said, just a 40-second victory in our final fight.
Very quick fight.
Of the evening.
I tried that one time and failed. I never tried it again. Very unique skill.
Fighters still waiting the announcement of the outstanding boxer of the evening. Fabulous night of boxing here at Clune Arena. It's been an absolute pleasure to be alongside you, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, my pleasure as well.
Alan Long winning the male outstanding boxer. He beat Sid Reyes at 165 pounds. Alan Long, your outstanding boxer from the male side. And Maddie Lloyd winning the outstanding boxer title. She beat Sam Thompson at 139 pounds.
Very well deserved.
Both fighters. General Clark, the superintendent of the United States Air Force Academy, in the ring as we pause for the third verse. Evening here in Colorado Springs at the United States Air Force Academy. That just about wraps up the 63rd annual Wing Open. What a wonderful night of boxing. Well, for our entire Falcon Vision crew, our director, Brian German, Tim Ceratore on replay, Grant Meach, Vince Greco, my friend, and Colonel Larry Hinken on cameras, and my broadcast partner, Kaneda Clifton Smith. Sir, it's been an absolute honor. I thank you for your service. I thank you for your time tonight. Please stay safe. Please stay well. I'm Roland Vargas. It's been an absolute pleasure to be with you tonight for the 63rd Wing Open from the United States Air Force Academy. Stay safe in the snow, everybody, and good night from Colorado Springs.
Stay warm.